Hello and welcome. I'm Christina Bellantoni, PBS NewsHour's political editor, and I'm here with science reporter producer Jenny Marder. And we are actually trying a little bit of an experiment, something new here at the NewsHour, to showcase some of the innovation going on in our own newsroom, which of course you can see right behind us. So I would say that wrapping and the PBS NewsHour are probably not things you would always put together, but we actually had a pretty cool project that you were working on with a bunch of others here in the newsroom. So tell us how we started asking people to make their own science rap videos.
Sure. Well, it stemmed out of a project that I was not working on, actually. It's a piece that aired on the NewsHour a couple months ago. It focused on a project at Columbia University Teachers College, where they went into schools in the inner city. They focused on a public school in the Bronx, and they basically used rap to teach kids about science. And Wu-Tang Clan's GZA actually collaborated with Teachers College and went into these schools and, you know, rapped with the kids.
Gravity that's going mad, clouds of dust and debris, moving at colossal speeds, they crushing MC. Since this rap region is heavily packed with stars, internal mirror in the telescope, notice the guards. From far away, we blink as a light to stroll with great distance of space between precise globe.
One of the NewsHour producers, Meryl Schwerin, had the idea that it would be, you know, wouldn't it be a great idea to turn this into a contest?
Yeah.
To turn this into a science rap contest. And we really had no idea what would come out of it, you know, how many people would get involved. But we were totally overwhelmed with entries. We had 105 entries. And some of them were just really kind of gritty, garage-style, homemade, you know, YouTube videos.
I saw a few. They were pretty good.
And some of them had a lot of, you know, really high production value. And, you know, a lot of the high school raps, for whatever reason, we got a lot about mitosis and meiosis and human reproduction. You know, I guess high school kids think a lot about human reproduction.
Human reproduction has a special function, the creation of life. Yeah, you know that I'm right.
We had another one that will actually come out in our expanded list. The person who made this just posted an iPhone text message screen. And he used, using just emoticons and symbols, you know, that you find on your normal iPhone keyboard.
Right.
He created these images that correspond with the video, and the video was called Universal Gravitation, and it's about gravity and Newton and gravitational force.
Realized they were caused by the same forces. This was a problem now that Newton knew that he could tackle. The sun pulls on the earth just like the earth pulls on the apple.
So what's the next step? We have some finalists. We're going to be putting those out. How are they getting judged?
Yeah, they had to have 16 bars of verse. They had to rhyme. They had to use metaphor. They had to mention whatever scientific subject they were talking about. They had to mention it several times. You know, we really wanted the science to teach you something.
Awesome. Well, very cool project. Thanks very much, Jenny Marder.
Thanks, Christina.